Faculty can teach conflict management skills to residents in all sorts of ways, but perhaps the most important way is by their own behavior. Medical students, residents, in fact, all members of the team constantly observe the work and the behavior we demonstrate as staff. So if faculty really want to teach good conflict management skills to the residents, they need to role model this in their daily practice. Now, there's a couple of things that faculty members can do to augment that work. Here at the University of Ottawa, we've promoted a course called Crucial Conversations and another course called Crucial Accountability to all of our residents and to all of our program directors, and we offer it to all of our faculty members. There's a reason why we do this. Here at the University of Ottawa, we have a strong belief in the value of respect and a strong belief in the value of collegiality. And these are courses that are designed to give people 10 specific skills to increase their capacity to manage conflict in the workplace. So if faculty members haven't had an opportunity to take those courses, I'd really encourage them to consider it. If you don't have time to take the course, then the two books, Crucial Conversations and Crucial Accountability, are marvelous reads. They're both fairly easy reads, and they're complemented by a host of online learning resources. So I'd encourage you to consider those. There's a couple of other things that faculty members can also consider. Here in Canada, we have access to the Canadian Medical Association's Physician Manager Institute, and that particular program offers several courses in conflict management. But perhaps more importantly, that program offers courses in self-reflection and self-assessment. And I think most of us know that if we understand ourselves well, we can minimize and manage conflict in the workplace. There's some other practical things that we can do at the point of care with our students and residents. Not only do we role model behavior, but we can also use opportunities that arise in conflict in the team to have special teaching moments with our trainees. Now, we need to be mindful about how we have these. We should have these conversations discreetly and privately where appropriate, but we can unpack what's going on in the dynamics of the team with residents directly. You can ask them probing questions. Do they see aspects of conflict? What strategies might they apply to mitigate things? Can they predict the natural and artificial consequences of conflict poorly and well managed? So those are STEM questions that we can use at the bedside around these issues. For some of our trainees, and certainly for some of us, issues of conflict can get quite serious. Sometimes it can take on a tone or a dynamic that can derail our satisfaction in the workplace. If you're dealing with those issues, or if you want to talk to your residents about how they can manage those issues, there's two resources you may want to think about. First, there's a lot of resources at the University of Ottawa for conflict support. People can reach out to the equity office, they can reach out to the wellness office, they can talk to the postgraduate medical education's wellness program. And then there's some other programs that they can consider reaching out to as well. The Ontario Medical Association's Physician Health Program can provide emotional support to members of our profession who are dealing with stress in the workplace, and can also offer some very pointed advice about how to manage some very difficult behavioral issues in the workplace. There's also two resources that we tend not to use a lot in medicine. One is mentorship. I think mentorship has a rich tradition in medicine, but I don't think it's actually well used because not very many people can actually define what mentorship is, talk about the actual process of mentorship, and then evaluate its outcomes. Regardless of that, lots of people like to use mentorship, and I would encourage people to continue to do so. My other recommendation for managing issues like this would be coaching. And coaching is an evidence-based, structured, professionalized approach to helping people solve their own conflict problems in the workplace. So those two particular approaches can be very helpful if people are facing really complex issues of conflict in the workplace.